My room is a mess, just like my life. Hey! So as you can probably tell from the title, this is a video for and about my best friend. So if you want to listen to me talk about one of the most important people in my life, then stick around. But if you don't, then come back next week and I should have either a songy covery thing or some other kind of video that may or may not interest you. So yeah. So Mariah, you made me a video a long, long time ago. Well, I guess it wasn't too long ago, it was a few months, but anyway, you made me a video because I asked. And you didn't ask for this, but I feel like we need it. And I want to do this. I want to start by telling our story. Mariah and I met in kindergarten, and we were inseparable off the bat. And one day I was at her house and I beat her at Mario Party. I don't remember which one it was, but it was a while ago. So it had to have been a lot of numbers ago. And I remember I was Princess Peach, which is weird because now she kind of annoys me. And I beat her. And that's when we stopped talking. I know that was completely coincidental because, like, she wasn't really mad. I mean, she was like, oh, you beat me, I hate you, blah, 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 but in reality, she wasn't really mad. And that's when I lost contact with her. She ended up leaving the school, and I lost contact with her for a really long time. And I was young, but it hurt me so much, and I would cry so much about it. If I remember correctly, your phone number stopped working, and I had just completely lost who am I talking to? Am I talking to you or people? Her phone number stopped working. That may or may not have happened. I think it did. And I was devastated. And I was afraid that I would never see my best friend again. And then middle school came along and I had seen her around a couple times and I was like, oh my god, that's her. And she had looked so much different. When I had first met her, she was this little girl with these, are they called banana curls? They just stuck out of her head and went down. And now she had had these basketball shorts and these sports jackets and her hair was back in a bun. And she looked so much different, but it was her. And I was really nervous to try and talk to her again because it had been a while and I'm a pretty shy person. We were put into the same art class together and we had been seated next to each other. I don't remember who said, do you remember me first? Mariah, I know you're watching this and you're screaming who it was. But I can't remember off the top of my head. I just know that that was a thing. And the other person was like, well, yeah, of course. And Mariah had said, well, I want to come to your house again. And for some reason, I didn't believe her. Probably because I just couldn't believe that this was happening, that I was getting my best friend back. And I was like, no, you're not. Like, I didn't think that she wanted anything to do with me anymore. I thought, oh, yeah, we were best friends and then we were young and now we moved on. And she was like, no, I'm serious. I'm gonna come. I was like, yeah, okay, sure. So we had a date, a time, and I waited for her and she showed up. And we went into my backyard and we played tennis with my dogs, I believe. And we've been best friends ever since. And then everything was cool up until high school. And then she moved. And I lost her again. And it was horrible. And I just couldn't believe this was happening to me again. And then she came back. And I was so happy because I loved having her around all the time. And when we went to the same school, she'd come home with me every day. And we were inseparable. We spent every second together that we could. When she came back, I was so happy. And she stayed for about a year. And then she ended up leaving again. And she's been gone since then. And that was a few years ago. And she's come to visit, but she hasn't visited me in over a year. And it's so hard to live without your best friend. And I'm sure some of the people watching this can relate. But I've had her torn from me several times, and I figured, well, it'll hurt at first, but I'll learn to live. And it never gets easier. Sometimes it gets harder. At first, I was kind of numb to it. And then it hit me that it had happened, and I was destroyed. And then some days, I'm okay. And then some days, I just want to lay in bed and ask God why my best friend isn't here anymore. And I'm the kind of person who isn't very outgoing, so I kind of cling to the people that I'm comfortable with. So Mariah was my rock through everything. It was just so empty for her to be gone. And now, Mariah, I want to talk to you. We keep in contact. We're always going to keep in contact. But lately, we haven't been as open with each other as we usually are. And I guess that's kind of the wrong way to put it. It's not that we're not being open, it's just that we're not really sharing much of anything at all. When we do talk, it's kind of meaningless things. It's not that we don't care, and it's not that we don't want to be friends anymore. It's not that we're giving up. It's none of those things. If anything, it's probably just pure laziness. But we've both noticed it. But I want to make this video to remind you what you are to me. Because I don't want you to forget that, and I don't want you to feel like you aren't those things anymore, because you are and you're always going to be. You've always been special. I don't mean that the way that sounds. You've always been special to me. You've always been different from everyone else. And this sounds like a marriage proposal. But seriously. For example, a lot of my friends, when we get in a fight, they treat it like it's the end of the friendship. I don't want to be your friend anymore. Blah, blah, blah. And then they start saying horrible, horrible things about you just because they're mad at you. And you've never been like that. You've always understood that just because you have a disagreement with somebody you care about doesn't mean that it's the end of everything. Yeah, you might be mad and you might ignore them for a bit. And maybe you do say some things that you don't mean when you're arguing with them, but they're usually relevant to the argument. Other people, they'll say things completely irrelevant just to hurt you. But you were never like that. You never set out to hurt me. When you were arguing with me, your goal was to prove your point. And a lot of the times that we argue, it's over us trying to help each other. And one person is being a brick wall, and the other person feels like they're preaching to no one. When I argue with you, it destroys me in a different way than it destroys me when I fight with other people. I'm always afraid of losing you, even though I know that you don't think an argument is the end of a friendship. I just feel so fortunate to have you in my life and have you as my best friend that every time there's a conflict, I say to myself, oh my god, I finally destroyed it. It's like I'm always on the edge. I'm always expecting myself to screw it up because the theme of my life seems to be nothing gold can stay, like that Robert Frost poem. Every time I have a really good thing, like you, it always seems to go away. And in a way that does apply to you because, I mean, you moved and you're not here anymore. And I have to live with that every single day. And when we hang out, a lot of the time I'll hang out with a friend and we'll sit there forever, just going back and forth. What do you want to do? What do you want to do? But with you, we don't even have to be doing anything and we're having fun. We have kind of the same mind. And we'll laugh at nothing, which sounds cliched to say between friends because I know a lot of friends laugh at nothing. But we come up with the stupidest things and we invent things to do for fun, like the chocolate bubbles and the hockey with the pencils and the marbles and the holy basket of uniqueness. We invent our own fun and we kind of enjoy the same things. Apart from two things where you have your sports and I have my singing, those are our differences, but you try to involve me in sports and we all remember what happened with that. She hit me in the face. She was trying to show our friend how to throw and how to catch. And I had the mitt and I was supposed to catch and she goes, okay, I'm gonna show you now. And then she throws it and I'm like, I got it, I got it. And then I get hit in the face. I still have a lot of the things that you made me on my door and a lot of the things that you wrote me. And I look at them sometimes and I don't know, I just want you back here. And I don't want you to think that I don't think about you just because maybe I don't message you as often as I used to. And I don't want you to think that we're slipping or that I don't care or any of those things, because those are not true. I care just as much as I always did, and I miss you more than I ever have, and I want you back here more than I want anything. I think everyone deserves to have their best friend by their side. You deserve to share your experiences with your best friend. You shouldn't have to talk to your friend through a computer screen and tell them what happened at school today, or call your friend in tears and explain why you're hurting. You deserve to have them next to you, hugging you while you cry into them. I don't know, these are lame, but none of these people are you. I have some friends here and I hang out with them sometimes. And I love them so much, but they're not you, and no one's ever going to be you, ever, in my life. No one could replace you. You've been with me through so many things in my life. You've seen me at my worst, and you love me anyway. And that's a cliched statement too, but it's true. Remember that one Halloween? You risked getting in trouble because I was in tears on my bed. I can feel how much you care, and I don't question it like I do with some other people. You're always a given in my life, and I'm so thankful for that. Another cliched statement, but a true one? I don't know where I'd be without you. This may seem like a lame example of this statement, but you introduced me to Damon Fizzy, and through him, I've made so many internet friends and people who have really been a good and helpful and great part of my life. And Damon has as well. Without you, I don't know that I would have found that environment. There are some things that you're the only person I feel comfortable telling them to. When you give me advice, you don't tell me what you think I want to hear. You don't tell me things to shut me up. You listen, and you're honest with me. Even if it makes me angry to hear the truth, even if it hurts me to hear it, you tell me what you honestly think is going to help me and what you honestly think that I need to hear and need to know. And I appreciate that. I appreciate that tough love so much because so many people will just say things to shut you up and they don't care. But you've showed me numerous times how much you care. And I believe that you care. I don't want you to ever feel like I don't think that you care, or I don't think that you love me, because I believe it. You've proven it to me. Because there are so many things that you wouldn't waste your time on if you didn't care. So I just want you to know that it never gets easier for me. I miss you all the time. I'd give anything for you to just be back here in person in my life like you used to be attached to my hip again, or just let me hug you and just see you. It's so hard going through life and growing up, having my best friend miles and miles away from me. And sometimes I get so frustrated because I don't know how to deal with it. And sometimes I feel really alone. And it's not enough to call you. I want you here in person again. I miss you, and I love you, and I hope that you're doing well. And I know that our friendship will last for our entire lives. We've come this far. There's no way that it can't. There's no way anyone could ever replace you. No one could ever do half the things that you've done for me. And I just want you to know those things. And yeah, bye.